let's begin now.
Today we're going to be reviewing American Honey.
American Honey.
All this stuff is wrong now.
American Honey is an independent film directed by Andrea Arnold, who's actually a British director. The movie follows and depicts the life of mad kids who, in rural America, go from door to door selling magazines to people like themselves who are in depressed areas of America, or, you know, some of them are oil barons or people who come from a lot of wealth. The leading role, played by Sasha Lane, who depicts the character Star, lives in a very depressed neighborhood. Her living situation at home isn't that great. She's raising kids that aren't hers, and she wishes to get away, where she happens upon Shia LaBeouf's character, Jake, who is actually a manager of this mag kids traveling crew, and he invites her along as a job opportunity. From there, Star really incorporates herself being a mag kid, and as an audience member, you really get a good idea and glimpse of how these kids operate. Throughout the journey, she questions herself and often finds things out about herself she didn't know was there. It's a really good coming-of-age story.
One of the things we really liked about this movie was the cinematography. Now, one of the things that you notice right when you start watching is that the frame is actually much boxier. It's less widescreen, so it's almost a 4:3 type of framing. Now, what this does is it makes it so that a lot of the shots are very close. A lot of the shots are very intimate. And this makes it feel like you're one of the mad kids living with these people, and you're actually just viewing it. It was a very guerrilla type of shooting where they gave someone a camera, and basically it was very documentary-esque, which kind of makes sense because it was produced by Vice, and it kind of feels like half a documentary.
Another one of the aspects of the film that we really enjoyed was the banter in between the mad kids.
I'm here. He's from Missouri. He really don't talk much about himself.
He's scared of flies, moths, birds, and damn near anything that flies.
Very real. It was very raw. And from what I understand, a lot of it was actually improv. So you're getting a lot of these kids in their natural state. They're not really reading from scripts. They're literally just putting it out there, listening to music that the director said, hey, throw this on or give me some recommendations and, you know, put this on and act how you kids act when you're listening to music. Don't, you know, orchestrate it.
So after the music,
who has
DJ control? I would say that too.
So through that, I think we can bring back a lot of that grittiness, a lot of that realism, and that kind of really helps with the atmosphere of the film being, you know, feeling impoverished, feeling like, you know, we don't have much, but we have each other. We have our music and we have our times that we spend together. The music in the film really brought to life this traveling band of misfits.
Spinning high like, yeah, sending every night, yeah, push start the wheel, running straight to life, from the light.
It was music that typically, you know, a lot of people who aren't familiar with hip hop would look at it and go, you know, oh, I don't know any white kids that listen to that music. But the way I looked at it as, it doesn't matter what color you are. The music speaks to them coming from a certain state. And that state is universal. It doesn't matter the language. Really helped bring in a kind of taste to the film that set it apart from others. And the music, it didn't have like an orchestral background or like a score. It was literally the music that they were listening to was the backdrop for this story. And I thought that was just beautiful. A lot of the time we get so bogged down with the day-to-day routine. And one of the things that this movie depicts beautifully is the freeform lifestyle that these kids are living. I mean, they're taking residence in motels that they can only afford to pay for. They're shacking up in seemingly abandoned houses. And the great thing about it is it just reminds you to live, to not worry about what you don't have, and then just embrace what you do.
So a couple of dislikes. I actually had a couple of things I disliked about this movie.
Okay.
One of them was the length. Even though you said you kind of liked, or you really liked the banter between the mag kids.
Right, right.
I feel like it came on a little bit too many times. I feel like there was way too many scenes of them just playing and dicking around and horsing around. I think I got the point in the first couple of scenes. I know it's supposed to build this, like you said, community, and it's supposed to build these characters together so that you like them and you see how they live, but I just didn't think it needed it that much.
And a half, 2 hours and 42 minutes. It is excessive when you think about the time, and they definitely could have scaled it down. I just thought it was, you know, so beautiful. For me, it wasn't too bad.
Another thing I didn't like about this movie was the main character played by Sasha Lane, Star.
Sasha Lane was great as the character. Some of her character nuances and moments weren't very likable, especially at the beginning.
No. So Sasha Lane is actually not a trained, classically trained actress or not trained at all.
No.
And the thing is, the director found her after the original actress dropped out. She found Sasha Lane on a beach.
Right.
And just asked her if she wanted to be in this movie. Right. And Sasha Lane said, yeah. The movie doesn't have that many scenes where Sasha Lane needs to, you know, flex her actress muscle. But at the same time, the way the character was written through most of the movie is there's really annoying points of that she has.
It almost seems like her motivation's misguided.
But at the same time, there's not a lot of redeeming qualities to her. She's just really annoying sometimes all the time. And I don't know why. I feel like we were supposed to root for her.
Right.
But for me personally, I didn't really get that feeling. She just had a lot of annoying moments, and you kind of felt like a parent at some point. Right. Just like, you wanted to just strangle her. Because, like, why are you doing this?
I feel the type of people who would like this movie are those viewers who like that freeform style of directing. You can almost relate this to early Terrence Malick films like, you know, Badlands or Days of Heaven, where, you know, you have a lot of those beautiful nature shots, very close-up, facial, you know, exposures, and it's very intimate. But at the same time, it's really just interested in the characters and just kind of where they go without a story being, you know, very ABC.
So for the people who I don't think would like this movie, the movie is really gritty. It's really raw. There's a lot of dirty moments in the movie. Also, there's a lot of sexual moments in the movie and nudity. So if you're opposed to that, or you want to watch this with your kid for some unknown reason, don't.
Don't do it.
Don't do it.
Don't do it.
And also, like Ken said before, one of the things that he disliked was the length of the film. I personally don't really look at length too much when it comes to film, but I know that really deters a lot of people. This movie's almost 3 hours, and like I said, it's not a very ABC story plotline. It's not even a character-driven story, but you're following characters and just seeing how they act in their everyday lives. So if that's something that might deter you, not just in the length, but just in not having a very conventional style of story, then this movie might not be for you. So my final rating for this movie was 8 out of 10. I do think it definitely has its drawbacks, but I think the strengths of the movie, the quality of this movie, overpowered them enough to where I can kind of overlook some of the things that I didn't enjoy about it.
So my final grade is 6.9 out of 10. It was a good movie. It was okay. There were drawbacks, like you said. The length of the movie really got to me. The extra scenes of the Mad Kids really got to me. And I feel like it was half a documentary, half a feature, and I didn't really know which one exactly wanted to be.
Right.
But the filming, the cinematography, just to kind of see it as a case study, if you were into that type of stuff, to see how you would film in a more 4:3 box. This movie is very interesting and it's very good to watch because of that.
What are you doing today?
Why?
You want to go to Kansas City?
Kansas.
Right now.
Now.
Right now.
What kind of dumbass are you asking random girls to go to Kansas with you?
Wow, no.
All right, well, this is Black and Yellow Movies. That was our review of American Honey. If you've seen it, comment below. Tell us what you thought about it. Tell us, I don't know, your favorite scene.
Favorite scenes, favorite aspects, characters, whatever. With an iPhone here and then the little stand, and that's how they're filming. It brings a raw, gritty realism to the look and feel of the film. The way not only it was filmed, but these characters, they really bring them to life. Yeah. And then their lifestyle that they live, it's so raw and gritty, and it's so unique. I'm not realizing anything that's different from my lifestyle. I'm just interested in theirs.
Girl, do you really want to go back to prison? You just got out, mama.
I told her that too.
Don't you act like prison is a bad place to go.
I read that the director, Sean Baker, actually said that he named the film and put a certain kind of filter on the iPhone camera because it reminded him of the LA sunset. Mm-hmm. And you really get that feeling. Like, I mean, a lot of it is kind of shot at dusk. It's a beautiful